Hello everyone, our today's topic is Introduction to ASP.NET. Till now we'll see many examples, many controls related to Windows application. Now it's time to learn ASP.NET. So ASP.NET is a part of .NET framework for building rich web applications. So if we want to create some websites, if we want to create some web application, we must have to use ASP.NET. ASP stands for Active Server Pages. It is an older Microsoft technology in building websites using server-side scripting engines. ASP.NET is a newer version over ASP from Microsoft with many advantages. ASP.NET is a web application framework developed and marketed by Microsoft. It allows programmers to build dynamic websites. It allows you to use full-featured programming language such as C# or VB.NET to build web applications easily. As we already learned that .NET support multiple languages, so we can use multiple languages like C#, VB.NET, J#, F# to develop our web application or website using ASP.NET. ASP.NET works on top of the HTTP protocols and uses HTTP commands and policies. As we already know, if we want to create some web application or if we want to create some website, we must have to deal with HTTP protocols. Over here, ASP already works on HTTP protocols. ASP is used to provide interactive, data-driven web applications over the internet. ASP.NET consists of large number of controls such as text boxes, buttons, and labels for assembling, configuring, and manipulating code to create HTML pages. The HTML components model provide various building blocks of ASP.NET pages. Basically, it is an object model which describes first is server-side counterparts of almost all HTML elements or tag. It covers basic HTML tags like forms, input, buttons, and so on. Second one is server controls, which helps in developing complex user interfaces. For example, calendar control, reach server controls, grid view controls, and so on. Now we'll start with the life cycle of ASP.NET. As we know, every programming language has its own life cycle. So ASP.NET has also its life cycle. The ASP.NET life cycle shows how ASP.NET processes the web pages to produce dynamic output. It also shows how the application and individual pages are instantiate and processed and how ASP compiles the page dynamically. The ASP.NET lifecycle starts when the client requests a web from the web server. Now over here, web server is nothing but it is a IIS servers on Windows systems. What is IIS? IIS stands for Internet Information Server. It is a web server that runs on Microsoft.NET platform on Windows OS. ASP.NET lifecycle could be divided into two groups. First is lifecycle of ASP.NET application and second is lifecycle of ASP.NET web pages. We'll start with the ASP.NET application lifecycle. Over here, total 5 phases are available for lifecycle of ASP.NET applications. We'll start with the first, that is user request for an application resource. It refers to the phases in which application resource is requested by user on web server. This request passes through the unified pipeline that calls ASP.NET module. Now, if a page has the HTML extension and is not explicitly mapped with ASP.NET, still this request can take benefit of the ASP.NET features such as authentication and authorization process. which are embedded in managed code. In IIS, this process requires manual configuration due to two separate pipelines. We are talking about IIS 6.0. In IIS 7.0, such thing is directly available. Now we'll see the second phase, and that is the unified pipeline receive the first user request. In this phase, it specifies that when a request for an application resource is received for the first time, an application domain is created by using object of application manager class. The application domain is process that isolates application from each other and enable the processing of user request. In this phase, the information about the application can be accessed when the hosting environment object is created within the application domain. Now we'll see the third phase of the ASP.NET application lifecycle, and it is for each user request and response object are created. This phase refers in which the response objects such as HTTP context are created. The HTTP content class object has a HTTP request and HTTP response. These objects are valid only for the current user request. The HTTP request object holds the information about the current request, whereas the HTTP response object holds the information that is sent to the user, such as cookies and final output. Now we'll discuss the first phase of the lifecycle of ASP.NET application, and it is an object of HTTP application class is created and allocated to the request. In this phase, the application is started when the object of HTTP class is created. However, if a global.aspx file is exist, then the object of the global.aspx class is created instead of HTTP application class. The global.aspx class is derived from HTTP application class and represent ASP.NET application. The module that needs to be invoked depends on parent application's managed code module. In addition, it also depends on which module are configured in the web.config file. You can add or remove modules by specifying the module name in the web.config file within the module elements of the system.web server section. Now we'll discuss last stage of the lifecycle of ASP.NET application, and this phase is the HTTP application class processes the user request. In this, the HTTP application class perform the following task or processes the user request. It validate the user request to confirm that it does not contain many malicious markup. It performs URL mapping specified in the URL mapping section of the web.config file. It invoked events and method in the specified order. It start from begin request and follow this way, and it end with pre-send request content. Now we'll move towards life cycle of ASP.NET pages. When a user requests for ASP.NET web pages, the pages passes through a number of stages that are collectively called lifecycle of ASP.NET web page. For example, the lifecycle of page begins when the user requests for web page and ends when the pages is rendered completely to the browser. These are the total 7 stages of ASP page lifecycle. It is start from page request, then it is move towards start, then next is initialization, next is load, next is postback event handling, next is rendering, and last one is upload. We'll start with the first, that is page request. In this stage, it specifies that page life cycles begin when the user requests for a web page. If the request is new one, then page is compiled and executed. However, if the request is old one, the cached copy of the page is sent without executing the page. Now we'll discuss the second stage of life cycle of ASP.NET page, and this is start. In this stage, the request and response property of the page are configured. The page also ascertains whether the request is an old or new one by using isPostback property. Over here, we can have to use isPostback property to check the request for a page is newer one or older one. At this stage, the page's UI culture property is configured. Next stage of this ASP.NET page lifecycle is page initialization. In this stage, each control on the page is assigned a unique ID by setting the unique ID property. At this stage, if there are any themes, then they are added to the pages. If the request is old one, then the postback data are not loaded and the control property values are still required to be restored to the view state value. Now we'll discuss the fourth stage of ASP.NET page lifecycle, and it is nothing, it is a load. In this stage, if current request is old one, then the property of controls on the page are loaded with the data from the view state and control state. Now we'll discuss the fifth stage of the ASP.NET page lifecycle, and this is postback event handling. In this stage, if the request made is old one, then any event handler can be invoked. After that, the validation control used the page invoked the validate method. In this state, validate method will be introduced, which is going to validate the controls, and for this is validate property is also used. Now we'll discuss this sixth stage of ASP.NET page lifecycle, and it is rendering. This is determine the prior to the rendering the page, the view state and all control on the page are served. While rendering the page, ASP.NET runtime environment invoke the render method for each control on the page and write the output of the rendering stage to the output stream object of the page response property. Now we'll discuss last stage of the ASP.NET lifecycle, and it is unload. It refers to the stage where response and request properties of the page are unloaded and the cleanup operation, if required, is performed. Now we'll see the ASP.NET page's lifecycle events. At each stage of the page lifecycle, the page raises some event which could be coded. An event handler is basically a function or a subroutine bound to the event. These declarative attributes such as onClick or handle. Over here we have many ASP.NET pages lifecycle events are available, but we'll discuss three among that, and these three are common page events. That first is pre-init. It refers to the first event that occurs during the lifecycle of ASP.NET web page. It is used to check isPostback property of the page to determine whether the page is being processed for first time. It also creates or recreate dynamic control. It sets the theme property and master page dynamically. In addition, it gets and set profile property values. Now we'll discuss third event of ASP.NET page lifecycle, and it is init event. It refers to the event that is raised after the initialization of all controls and apply skin setting. It is used to read or initialize control property. This event can be handled overloading the onInit method or creating a pageInit handler. Now we'll discuss last event, that is load event. It refers the onload event method that is called to set the property of control and establish database connection. The page class first calls the onload event method on the web page and then calls the event for each child control until the page is loaded. This event can be handled by overloading onload method or creating page load handler. That's it from lifecycle events. In our next lecture, we'll discuss controls for ASP.NET. Thank you. Thank you very much.